I'm so excited.
Oh my God, we're really doing it.
We're doing the damn thing. This is long overdue.
I know. It's been months in the making.
Months in the making. We've had messages come in.
Really? I got it the day we recorded, but then I also got like more tweets about it and like DMs. Gosh. I got a lot of like, oh my God, so excited about this duo when I posted that I had you on the podcast. People were so excited.
That's so cute. Yeah, I got a bunch of messages after that too. And I was like, I love her. So the feeling's mutual. And then literally you posted last night for the 1 million and my friend was like, oh my God, how do you know her? I'm like, she's my new friend.
I know. Well, you messaged me on TikTok. And I, like, it was right when I had kind of stopped using TikTok. So it took me a while to, like, see it. Yeah. And then I was like, oh, my God, this girl's so funny. And then I followed you on Instagram for a while before you noticed, I think.
Maybe. <Yeah. laughs> But then you commented on something of mine. I was like, oh, my God, let me just go, like, fucking fangirl over here.
Yeah, because I think I'd been following you for a while and you, like, hadn't noticed or, like, followed me back or something. But then I commented on something and then you're like, oh, hi. And I was like, let's do it.
Yes, making new friends at 27 and 24.
I've been making such good friends this year.
You're like a pro at making new friends.
I've been doing well lately.
Well, you guys have probably recognized her voice by now, but I have a very special guest.
Are we recording?
Oh, yeah. We're going for it.
Is this for the, okay.
It's coming full circle from earlier episodes. Mm-hmm. But I have a very special guest today, you guys. You may have recognized her voice, but I'm being joined by Michaela Okland.
Yes, that's how it's pronounced. It's spelled weird.
Yes.
It's Michaela Okland. She rates dogs.
Yes.
If you've heard of it, not real dogs, it's men.
You guys, if you haven't checked out the Twitter account and the Instagram account for She Rates Dogs, please do. And for our male listeners, you know.
Listen up.
take notes on what not to do from this account.
But yeah, and then we have She Rates Dogs, a podcast, which Morgan came on a couple weeks ago. Something recently.
It was such a good episode, you guys, so make sure you check that out as well.
We went into your occupational therapy info in all of your binders. So very fun to see that side of you. I think it's really interesting to hear you talk about that stuff.
I know, I like bury it down. And then I have like, again, there's listeners that come out and they're like, I'm an OT too. And I'm like, wow.
That's so cute.
let's jump in. Today, we're going to be talking about dating and just relationship stories.
Okay, I love that.
Hi, guys. Before we jump into the new episode with Michaela, I just wanted to give you my two-week update after using the Function of Beauty shampoo and conditioner. I love it. I don't know if it was because my quiz was spot on, because I went fragrance-free, dye-free. I don't know what it was, but my hair is loving it. I'm loving it, and I'm really noticing a difference and working my way towards my hair goals that I wanted. So highly recommend you guys check it out. Another tidbit that really drew me into this brand was the fact they're cruelty-free, 100% vegan, sulfate-free, paraben-free, and sustainability-focused. But you guys should head there and take your free quiz to see if your goals are attainable and to see if you're interested in the formula that they create for you. So, for my little spiel, never buy off the shelf just to be disappointed again. Go to functionofbeauty.com/2HT to take your quiz and save 20% on your first order. And that applies to their range of customized hair, skin, and body products. So again, go to functionofbeauty.com/2HT, that's the number 2HT, and let them know we sent you to get 20% off your first order. Enjoy, guys. I think you're a content expert on
I curate some of that stuff.
You're gonna thrive with these stories then. Absolutely thrive. So the first one is a listener write-in. She goes, me, 22 female, and my boyfriend, Jacob, 25 male, have been dating for 3 years. He's always been the fun, bubbly type person in the friend group. Always smiling, always laughing, always up for a chit chat. 6 months ago, January 2021, due to COVID, we haven't been able to travel anywhere and we used to go on little weekends away. We live in Australia and the country is back open for travel. So I was like, let's organize a little weekend away. He was all down for it. We went to the Hunter Valley, a winery region. I don't know what happened on that trip, but he has been depressed ever since. Doesn't laugh, doesn't smile, doesn't ever want to talk. It's like something clicked in his head and he just changed. There was no leading up to this. He then starts mentioning his ex.
Oh, okay. Now it's starting to make sense.
We never really bring up our ex partners. All I know is me and her are complete opposites. Taylor, she's blonde, 5'3", Australian Elwoods. Me, brunette, 6 feet, farm girl.
6 feet? Races go off, dirt queen. Bikes.
Yeah, seriously. A little model. One night during sex, he called me Taylor.
Wait, the ex's name?
Yeah.
No.
Maybe a couple weeks after that, I was cooking dinner and he said, oh, Taylor would cut the bread this way. I kind of just ignored it because at this moment, he's in a really depressed state. He had made a few more comments saying,
I would take that knife and
fuck up the bread.
Don't say that to your girlfriend when she's holding a knife. Sorry. Continue.
Like, what? Dude, it's bread. Why does it matter?
Mm-hmm.
He has made a few more comments saying Taylor did this or like this over the next couple 2 months. 3 months ago, in April 21, his dad passed away in a car accident, which sent him into just a spiral. It was the deepest part of his depression. I've never had a problem with his family. They're welcoming, always there if I need anything. Very, very supportive. I'm there trying to support his mom because she just lost her husband by cooking meals, cleaning around the house. She said, you've missed a spot on the floor over here. When Taylor would mop the floor, she wouldn't miss a spot.
What the fuck?
This made my blood boil. Another day, I had it over there. I was just wearing like sweats and a jumper, like I'm going to go cook food and don't need to be looking like $1 million. He said, if Taylor was the rock at my house, she would look presentable. So I walked out.
Why is she still putting up with this, queen?
Am I the asshole for walking out?
No!
Will I be an asshole if I leave my depressed partner?
No!
Is she an asshole to compare me to one of his ex-partners?
Yes. What the actual fuck?
And this is disturbing.
This is very disturbing. And this started before, like, he was dealing with all of the family issues.
Yeah.
So it's not like this is just something extreme happened in his life and now he's reminiscing.
The initial thing, like, started in January and he didn't lose his dad until April.
Why is he so obsessed with his ex? At first, I was thinking maybe she got, like, engaged or something, so he was a little sad and, like, whatever, you know. If someone from your past has, like, a huge life moment, maybe it just kind of makes you reevaluate where you are and think about the life you could have had. And
so true.
Whatever. But this seems like he just...
It's out of nowhere.
...randomly wanted her back.
Well, I'm like, it seems that way. I think the shoe really fits with, like, maybe something popped up, like she got engaged.
Yeah.
Or maybe she reached back out. Because otherwise, if this person, you know, they've been dating for, oh gosh, what did she say here? They've been dating for 3 years.
What the actual, I do not think about my exes when I'm dating someone. Like, no. I'm sorry. I can understand accidentally saying the wrong name maybe one time. If that was the only thing.
Yeah.
If that was all that he had done, it'd be like, okay, whatever.
Yeah.
But if his mom is saying these things, like, you know, these people only get their information from, like, their child who's involved. So any opinion that she has is based on the way that he's talking to her.
For sure.
So
he's probably made some comments.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Please dump him. And also, like, people's mental health is important, but you don't have to shoulder another person's mental health and be like, oh, now I have to compromise myself to fix this person, because you would compromise yourself, you'd fix them, and then they'd be good for someone else. So you don't need that.
Just literally drop the mic. Like, yes, that's so, so, so important. I think the name during sex is like,
oh, I would lose my mind. I would lose my shit. I would kill them with a knife. But like, if I'm talking to someone else, I can pretend that I did. That's maybe okay.
Yeah,
and like, happens.
I'm gonna throw myself under the bus so fucking hard right now. So when I started dating my current boyfriend, we were like very new, very early on. I think it was like honestly maybe the first time we had sex.
Uh-huh.
And I called him the wrong name. I called him one of my guy friend's names.
Are you still friends with that guy friend?
Yeah. Like, he's like a brother to me. Like, truly like a brother. Like, nothing's ever happened. But we all had, like, gone to a concert earlier in the night. Like, he was actually staying here in the room next door. And me and Justin were hooking up. And I accidentally said his name. And he's like, he just like ignored it. Like he told me this next morning. I was like, what?
No. Oh my God.
No. And he's like, yeah. So I just have to ask, like, is anything going on like there? And I'm like, absolutely not. Like, I'm sorry. I was just drunk. I must've been worried about him being in the other room and hearing something.
Well, also if you have like a reflexive pattern, like when I would fight with my ex, there were times I almost called him Matt, who is my gay best friend.
Yeah.
And like, obviously there's no kind of sexual romantic thing between Matt and I, but like I fight with Matt. So sometimes when I'm just like caught up in that moment, I'll be like, oh, I'm used to saying this name when I'm like arguing.
Yeah.
So sometimes that happens, but I've not had that happen during sex. I think that's because I don't say names that often during sex.
I don't either. It's kind of weird. So I don't even know what I was doing that night. It was,
I don't blame you,
too much wine. But yeah, so I get it if it's early on or like new, but like
three years in, he's probably been jacking off to her. Like, sorry, I hate to say it. But if he's like,
there's something going on there
during a sexual experience 3 years later,
there's something going on there.
We don't like this man. And props to you for like taking care of his family and putting so much effort into like being a rock for other people. But they're like chipping away at you as a rock.
Well, and that's the other thing too. Like the comment, like, oh, my ex-girlfriend would look more presentable. Like, this girl is going above and beyond, cooking, cleaning.
Yeah.
Like, yes, you guys went through a very traumatic thing that is horrendous. But she's, you know, going above and beyond to make sure that your family's taken care of, and you're going to comment about something so petty as appearance.
Yeah, it's one thing if someone were to say, hey, like something came up in my mind about my ex. I don't have any idea why. I'm just like a little bit confused over it.
Yeah.
As opposed to being like, I'm going to knock you down and like make you feel bad about yourself saying, my ex cuts bread better.
The most irrelevant fucking thing too, bread.
I cannot imagine. I would literally kill a man. And this woman sounds like a saint.
Yes. OP, if you're listening, not the asshole.
Dump him, please.
If you walk out. Yeah, you definitely deserve better. And I'm very sorry for his loss, but.
Yeah, sorry to that man. But, oh, yeah. I thought you meant his loss of her. But
both.
Both, yeah. Both. Sorry to his losses.
Yeah, both. Poor guy. And like, you deserve better.
Yeah, text Taylor. Maybe she'll come cook. I don't know.
Yeah, hit Taylor up. Send her over. Up next, another listener write in. I think my boyfriend's brother has a crush on me. I, 18 female, have been living with my 19 male boyfriend and his family for 6 months now. I have a suspicion that his 20 male brother has a crush on me.
Wait, how old is she again?
18.
Okay.
My boyfriend works long hours and is in the U.S. National Guard as well. So there are times that I am home when my boyfriend is not. I found that during these times, his brother seems to talk to me more often and hang around me more. My boyfriend is away right now with the military, working 7 days, and some nights he sleeps over there. Well, the nights he has slept over, his brother comes into my room and tries talking to me for hours on end. I don't want to be rude and tell him to leave me alone. I try to act annoyed or tired so he will leave, but it never seems to work. As I'm writing this now, I am with my boyfriend's family, with the exception of my boyfriend, in a car. The brother and I are in the back seat, and he reached over and tickled my thigh.
What?
He's done stuff like this before, teasing me, and it makes me super uncomfortable. I don't know how to say something to him or my boyfriend. The brother has literally told me he wants a girlfriend who is like me. Am I being crazy, or am I catching the wrong vibe?
Okay, this is such a common experience, not in the sense of like someone's brother, but in the sense of like, my boss is flirting with me, but it's like a tricky relationship because I don't want to like upset someone in this position. Like, I don't want to upset my boyfriend's brother because I want the family to like
me. Well, she lives with them.
Right. So I don't want to like be presumptuous and like be so mean in turning him down that it's like, oh, I wasn't even going there. But at the same time, it's like you're getting these clear vibes where you're like, how do I make it clear without like, you know what I mean?
With someone tickling you
on the thigh, I would scream. I would punch reflex. I would like hit somebody in the face.
Oh, the hand would get smacked away so fast.
That's my least favorite part of The Bachelorette. I'm like, she has to have so many men put their hand on her thigh. That poor woman.
Yeah, I'm not a very like touchy-feely person.
Yeah.
Like, I am not about it. So, like, someone touching my thigh is, like, the exact opposite of what I want. Like, especially, like, this is his brother. Like, it's so creepy and weird.
Yeah, has she talked to the boyfriend about it yet? Doesn't I feel like that like is step one.
Step one, yes. Like, and I get, like, questioning, like, oh, am I overthinking this? Maybe he's just being friendly.
Right. But you don't even have to approach it like that. You can just be like, your brother is honestly just interacting with me too much. Like, he's trying to talk to me for hours at night. I'm uncomfortable with that. I'm uncomfortable when he's touching me. Like, she doesn't even have to say that she thinks it's from a place of him trying to get with her. She can just be like, this amount of intimacy is too much for me and I don't like it.
Set a solid boundary for sure. I think it's totally fair, especially like touching you and coming in your room. Unwanted.
I wouldn't want anybody to come talk to me for hours, like, unless I truly care for them and it's like a friend or something. But why? Yeah.
No, this is a big, big no for me. I would address it like yesterday.
She should also get a taser if he tickles her leg again.
100%. Mm-hmm. Well, and you just like get scared too. Like, say he did something when the brother wasn't there because the brother's gone a lot. And then he's like, oh, well, she wanted it.
Like, he
she
clearly has a lot of audacity.
Yeah.
So.
In the back seat of a car with their parents up front.
Yeah, which is why I feel like talking to the boyfriend and establishing that this is kind of like a vibe she's getting now is important in case that were to be a
Something
future situation.
Happen. Yeah.
I don't know. That's.
Yeah.
But that happens all the time, like, with bosses or with, like, work people or school people. Mm-hmm. It's like, I don't want to jeopardize this, like, relationship by being so rude in the way I say no.
Yeah.
But men will, like, abuse that and, like, continue to find their little opening. It's like, she hasn't outright, like, said, I never want to have anything to do with you sexually ever in my life. So, like, I can keep trying these little things.
Yeah. I think as women, like, there's a lot more pressure when we do say no, to like say it politely.
Yeah.
And like even this weekend we went out and Lauren, one of my friends, was talking to like this owner of this restaurant we went to. Mm-hmm. And he got her number and like she texted him and was just like, thank you. You know, we had a great time last night. And he was like, oh, thanks. I'm glad you came. Would you like to get dinner with me? And she was like, I'm sorry. Like, I have a boyfriend.
Right.
And he's like, fuck you. It's always the I have a boyfriend. You could have just told me you weren't interested. Blah, 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 blah. Like, popped off on her. And it's like, but she does have a boyfriend.
Yeah. Like that's honestly a pickup artist thing to do, is that they put things in a way where you can't say no. So, like, I was at Nordstrom Rack the other day, and this guy approached me with his phone out and was like, are you seeing anybody? And I was like, no, thank you.
Just quick.
And he was like, okay, sorry, and walked away. I was like, I'm not gonna like do this song and dance where it's like, no, I don't have a boyfriend, but that doesn't imply I'm interested in you.
Yeah.
I don't know.
No, thank you. God, that's, you got a good response there. I say no.
Literally, a man approached me at a club one time and asked what my name was, and I said, no, thank you.
Oh my gosh, I love that. The confidence.
Thank you.
I'm just like a shy, like introverted little person. Like when people come approach me, I'm just like, I just like don't know what to say. And then I like end up giving them my number.
Yeah.
And then I don't text them back.
Yeah.
Because I just like can't handle a confrontation. So I need to try this.
I've done like the fake number before, but the worst is when they'll like then be like, I'm going to call you right now. It's like, that will just embarrass both of us. Why do that?
I've done that. And then I like, I would like give one number away.
Mm-hmm.
Or like I give them my little brother's number.
But it was our waiter. So I was like, be nice to your service workers, but I guess don't be too nice because they'll ask for your number and then you'll have to lie.
Oh no, poor little friend. Yeah, you're not crazy though. Talk to your boyfriend ASAP. Yeah,
I'd say that's step one for sure.
ASAP Rocky. Up next, this one.
Oh, you look excited.
This one gave me wild ideas.
Okay.
My 23 female boyfriend, 23 male, showed his mom our sex painting, and I'm embarrassed.
Sex painting?
Learn something new today with this one. His mother, 63 female, was talking about getting something framed, and he said, oh, I got something framed once. It's not cheap. His mom asked what it was, and he sent the painting to his mom. Here's where it gets weird. His mom showed the painting to a random woman in her office. The woman was like, that looks like a sex painting. So my boyfriend never actually told his mom it was a sex painting, but he sent it to her and she figured it out. Next thing you know, we meet his mom and some of her friends at a bar and they were looking at our painting and discussing it.
Oh.
When I sat down, she started asking me all about it, getting all excited, saying I need to show her where I got it so her and her husband can try it too.
Oh, no.
She then wanted me to go sit next to one of her coworkers and tell them about it as well. The whole time, I was extremely embarrassed and my boyfriend was trying to get his mother to shut up. I understand that he didn't explicitly tell his mom it was a sex painting, but he still sent it to her without making sure it was okay with me first. I feel a little betrayed because this was a private painting that was between us and we have it hanging in our bedroom. It wasn't really intended for all eyes, especially his mother and her coworkers.
Yeah.
When I asked him why he did it, he said, because she asked to see it and I didn't think she would show other people. Is me being upset and embarrassed warranted, or is it an overreaction? What can we/I do to fix this? Any advice would be appreciated.
Okay. Oh my God. First of all, I would love to have like a visual of what the sex painting looks like, but obviously you.
Like what some of them look like.
Oh, okay. Because like if it's almost a nude, obviously you don't want other people to see that. Also, I get weird vibes, no shade to anyone who's like comfortable talking about their sex life with their parents.
I
think that probably is healthy. Like one of my friends, her mom is a gynecologist, so obviously they've always pretty open about that kind of thing. But sometimes I'm like, why do you talk about
there's a line. I'm like very, very open about sexuality.
Yeah.
But like I'll talk about it with my mom, like me, my mom and my uncle who's gay. Like we sat down and talked about sex one day and literally got so like deep into it to like talk about penis size.
Mm-hmm.
And like, that's like, okay, that's crossing a line for sure. But I also grew up with my dad who is just like the most inappropriate person, like his sexual jokes. So it's like, you're going to talk about sex one way or another, whether you like it or not.
Would you show them a painting of you and your boyfriend having sex?
So this is what it is. So upon further research, sex painting is you buy like a blank canvas, like this website I'm on.
Oh, okay.
You can like buy a kit. And so you put non-toxic paint all over your bodies.
Okay.
Have sex on the canvas.
Ooh.
And then whatever you get left with is like what your painting is, and then you frame it.
Okay, so that's a bit different than I thought. I thought it was like someone painted a photo that was like a still shot from a sex tape or so. I have no idea. But that, I guess, that's less intrusive, in my opinion.
For sure. You guys, it literally looks like someone, I don't know, if you've seen the Princess Diaries and you see the painting of like them popping the balloon darts, it's just like paint all over. Like it's very abstract. There's not really anything to tell.
I totally would be like a bit uncomfortable and embarrassed, but I think that's like just somewhere you would set a boundary.
Some of them are so cool.
They are very cool.
Yeah, I kind of want to do it.
Yeah, I mean, you can never tell someone like, no, your boundary is weird. But like for something like that, I feel like all you have to do is say, hey, just so you know, this is my boundary.
Yeah.
Like for future reference, would rather you don't talk about our sex life with XYZ or like show them an intimate moment or like that was something that I really just wanted between us. I don't know. If my boyfriend, I don't have a boyfriend, but if I did have a boyfriend and if he told his parents or showed them our sex painting, I would be like humiliated. But it's also like his family, so he knows the line, like if his mother would be uncomfortable with that or like think anything of it.
Yeah. Well, the fact that she's into it and like wants to get one.
Yeah. I think it makes it clear that like this wasn't a big deal to them.
No.
But yeah, I wouldn't want people showing around my sex painting, I guess.
I know. It's like, yeah, you framed it in your bedroom and like, I guess like, I don't know, like maybe a lot of people don't go in your room and like see your room. But
I wouldn't say it's a betrayal of trust.
No, I think it like, honestly, if I would have seen this and this was hanging in someone's house or like a gallery somewhere, I never would expect like, oh, two people made that by fucking on it.
Yeah.
Like,
and also that feels like, and maybe it's just because we live in Los Angeles, but that feels like something a lot of people would just have in their living room.
For
and
sure.
Be like, yeah, that's us making love.
I mean, like, did you see the TikTok trend of people like sitting their ass on paint and then like going and sitting on a canvas?
I didn't see that, but that does sound lovely.
Yeah, that was like a big trend. And then there's these other influencer girls.
Oh, the Kim Kardashian, like, this is probably not what you're saying. The like statue, they made like a body mold of their like naked bodies.
Yes. That is a thing.
I like those.
I think that's so cool, especially if you do it like when you're pregnant.
I know. That's really so cool.
But no, there's these two influencers, and like the only reason I know about them is like my ex-boyfriend paid like 10 grand for their ass cheek painting.
What?
But they're like these two twins, and
so fuck your ex-boyfriend, first of all. That's so weird.
He's an ex for a reason.
He paid $10,000.
Yeah, literally.
That's like when that e-girl sold her bath water. Like, who's buying? Oh my God.
Yeah. Yeah, it's very cringy.
Good riddance to him.
And the funny part was too, he's like, it's gonna be an investment. I'll probably make money on this. Like, they're only blowing up.
What?
I'm like, okay. Like, just literally you could have two girls sit on a canvas. Like,
yeah.
That's all it was. Like, good for them. Like, get the coin, girls. Like,
yeah,
love
they're
it.
Killing it. They are scamming, girl bossing. They are absolutely doing their thing.
Yeah.
But the man who spends $10,000.
It blew me away.
That's so concerning.
Blew me away. Yeah. So, I don't know. I'm super open about sex mm-hmm. and sexuality. So, for me, like,
yeah,
honestly, I would probably... I don't know if I'd send a picture to my boyfriend's mom, but if it came up, I wouldn't be embarrassed to be like, oh yeah, this is what we did. Like,
yeah, I think this is just more a sense of like, you have a very different boundary than him. And like,
sure.
You are not one of those people who would hang it up in your living room and be like super comfortable with it.
Yeah.
But maybe he just didn't really realize that you felt that way about it. And just be like, yo, like, this is how I feel moving forward and you're fine.
Please don't share it.
Yeah.
Easy conversation to have.
Super easy.
Yeah. She doesn't give any edits about like how she approached it. But
I'm glad we looked up what a sex painting is, because I felt very differently when it was like, oh, perhaps this is like a painting of them naked. Like, yes, oh, that's so uncomfortable.
Like Renaissance
yeah.
style.
No, literally, which I actually do love that idea
as well.
I think that sounds awesome, but I would not want anyone's mother to see.
No. No, that would be, if it's a realistic painting, that would be a little different for sure. Yeah, top comment on this one. How on earth did the mom's friend recognize that? It doesn't sound like it would really look like anything in particular.
Yeah, to be fair, in her boyfriend's defense as well, I feel like he probably didn't think his mom would know it was a sex painting based on what they look like.
No. But I also hope, like, perfect Christmas gift to get your mom.
So true.
They're not bad either. If anyone wants one of these kits.
Well, you just get them like a canvas and some paint, right?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
Obviously non-toxic.
This website that I found them on by Googling just literally sex painting, it's $60 for the whole kit.
Oh.
It's a steal.
And you make a beautiful memory.
Exactly. I know what I'm getting my boyfriend for his birthday.
I hope that like when they did that, they had good sex so that whenever they look at it, it's like a good memory. You know what I mean? Imagine if it just reminded you of like a horror sex story.
Oh, yeah. Hopefully it was good.
Mm-hmm.
So up next, my 23 female boyfriend, 25 male, won't stop eating ants. And I don't know what to do.
What? Okay.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever eaten?
I mean, like, if I'm at a nice restaurant, I'll go with it and trust them and be like, okay, I'll try octopus or I'll try frog.
Snails.
Or I'll try, yeah, like, I'll give it a go because, you know, this is a nice place. But never off, like, the ground have I eaten those things.
Yeah, this is weird. I kind of kick myself, like, when I was in Thailand. Mm-hmm. I wish I would have tried, like, the little scorpions or something.
Oh, no, I could not go that far.
Oh, no, okay, that's off limits. I don't know.
Well, just because of, like, what an alive scorpion can do, that just scares me. Not because I think it's, like, gross. I would try other insects, I guess, like...
A grasshopper?
Yeah.
Well, guys, if you've made it this far in the episode, I'm probably about to break your heart because it broke mine, at least. But During the recording with Michaela, I ran into some technology problems, and I didn't even know until we had already finished recording, which is so annoying because right before my phone ran out of storage and stopped recording the video episode, I got up to check it to make sure it was still recording. So from here on out, there is no longer video evidence of this episode, and I hope you can forgive me. And just know that I'm going to do everything in my power to prevent this from happening again. Because this was truly an amazing episode, and I'm so grateful for Michaela joining. But I hope you enjoy the audio version and staring at a picture of us smiling. There will be some parts where we talk about images, and I've included those still. So rest assured, you'll get the full picture of what we were talking about, minus our horrified faces. Hope you can forgive me. I had an absolute meltdown when this happened, and my dad was kind enough to give me his camcorder for future episodes so I don't run into this problem again. So please forgive me and enjoy the rest of the episode with Michaela.
Is there more context for this story?
There definitely is.
Because do we know if they're like candied or if they're off the ground?
We're going to find out.
Okay.
My boyfriend and I have recently moved in together after dating for 2 years. I was nervous about moving in together at first, but I was pleasantly surprised how easy and natural it felt to merge our lives together. In a lot of ways, we are very compatible and he makes my life happier.
Just not the ants.
However, recently, he has developed a strange habit. I know that it's normal for partners to have habits or idiosyncrasies that might annoy one another, but this is one that I don't know if I can put up with. It all started when we were watching a survival show together.
Oh, no.
One of the contestants decided to snack on some ants as a protein source.
Right, and they also drink their own pee on their shows. Like, you don't need to be doing that either.
No. This caused my boyfriend to wonder what ants taste like, and he became curious to try one.
Okay.
I didn't think much of it at the time because I didn't think he would actually do it. Well, the next day, while we were cooking together, I noticed some ants crawling on the sink. I asked my boyfriend to take care of it, since he is usually the one to kill any bugs in our apartment. Mm-hmm. To my surprise, instead of killing the ants, my boyfriend popped one of them in his mouth and ate it.
Alive or dead?
Alive.
What the fuck?
I thought this was hilarious and a little gross, and I asked him what it tasted like. He said that it tasted slightly sour, like a lemon-lime flavor. Mm. And it wasn't bad.
Okay.
My boyfriend is a bit of a jokester, so I assumed this was just a one-time thing that he did to make me laugh. Mm-hmm. The thing is, our apartment has a bit of an ant problem. We've tried everything from ant traps to coffee grounds, but we can't seem to get rid of them. Now, every time my boyfriend sees an ant, instead of killing it, he will simply pop it into his mouth. I think this is disgusting, and frankly, I don't want to kiss the same mouth that has been eating ants. I know that in some cultures, eating ants is perfectly acceptable, but this is just too strange and taboo for me to get used to.
Right.
I've tried telling him to stop eating ants, but I've noticed that even after he said he would stop, sometimes I catch him doing it when he thinks I'm not looking.
He's obsessed.
I don't know what to do. Am I being dramatic?
Okay. Yes, in cultures they do eat ants, although, like, I don't know how they prepare them, but these are just, like, wild ants walking around the ground. Like, they're not being cleaned or cooked. They're just, like, free ants.
Also, like, an ant is, like, the size of a grain of pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Like, how do you know you're chewing it and then actually swallowing it? What if it's just, like, chilling in your mouth?
Yeah, I feel like if...
What if it got stuck in your tooth?
If he was, like, taking these ants, making some kind of meal with them, cooking them up.
Like a bunch of ants in a bowl.
Yeah. I don't know, making some kind of crunchy...
Like a crunchy rice dish, like something like that.
Yeah. I don't think that, like, eating ants in that way would be super weird, but the fact that he's just, like, I feel like he just thinks he's, like, an apex predator right now, and, like,
God.
He's like, I am, what's the, Bear Grylls?
Oh, my God.
Is that who he thinks he is?
Yeah.
By doing this, like, you don't have to. Like, you live in a home.
You're not in Naked and Afraid.
You're not on, like, an abandoned island. You can just, like, eat good food. I don't know. I think it's very interesting that, like, she's asked him to stop eating these ants. And he's like, no. Like, this is me now. I love this shit. He's probably texting his friends, like, guys, I'm, like, literally hunting and gathering.
Probably. And, like, oh, I'm upping my protein. Like,
that's probably what he thinks. He probably just thinks he's, like, doing a really big protein thing.
Like, there's not a lot of carbs in these ants. Like, my macros.
Also, if they've been, like, trying to get rid of ants with other means, like, what if they have, like, chemicals on them?
Oh, my God.
You know what I mean? Like, if they've been trying to get rid of these ants with other methods.
Yeah.
Like, these are not clean ants.
Yeah.
I'd be worried. Maybe she could tell him that she's worried about his health or something.
Seriously, because I can't imagine these ants have enough protein to, like, be substantial for his diet or like healthy or adding any benefit.
She's like, please stop. And he's like, no. Maybe take him to a nice restaurant where they prepare ant meals once a week and he can get his fix that way. Or find like a bar on Amazon. I don't know.
There's weird restaurants out there that have like these delicacies, like the grasshoppers and all of that.
I would definitely try that, but I would only try it in like a professionally professionally prepared environment.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't want to be too judgmental because like it's actually a normal thing other places.
It is, yeah.
But it does sound very funny.
I this might be a deal breaker for me. Like if my boyfriend continued to eat ants he found, like, scrounging around our apartment.
Like, and I totally understand that she's like, oh, my God, and then he tried to put his tongue in my mouth, and I wasn't into it.
Yeah,
like,
no.
If someone's putting their tongue in your mouth, you can tell them you're uncomfortable with something else that they're putting in their mouth.
Just say you have an ant allergy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, be like, oh my God, have anaphylactic shock.
Yeah, oh, my God, babe, my tongue has been swelling up lately, and the only thing that's changed is you're eating raw ants now.
You're going to put me in the hospital if you keep eating these ants. Yeah, that if nothing else works, maybe that would.
Just try lying. There was this girl that said her parents told her she had a gene where if she smoked weed, she would shit her pants.
Oh my God, I saw this. So
which is like
sneaky.
The most convincing way to get someone to just not try things in public situations.
Yeah.
She's like, it's a gene. People in my family shit their pants if they
I
have
would never
weed.
Try it.
So I think that's so smart.
So smart.
Sometimes you lie a little.
Sometimes a little white lie can be very helpful. Especially, you know, if it's going to ruin you socially. Because, like, where does he draw the line? Like, if he went to a restaurant and was outdoors and he saw a couple ants.
Oh, yeah.
What,
you can't take him anywhere.
You can't take him anywhere.
He's addicted to ants now.
He's addicted to ants, which, speaking of bugs.
Oh, transition. Nice transition moment.
Mm-hmm. Am I the asshole for throwing away my husband's couch? He is pretending to be a beetle. And it's driving me nuts.
What? He's pretending to be a beetle?
A beetle.
Does he have some kind of couch that he likes to hide under?
I think that's the vibe.
Okay.
I think that's the vibe. Backstory. My 33 female husband, 35 male, is a successful actor in film and theater. Hmm. He's very good and very seriously dedicated to his craft. He is a firm believer in method acting.
This is Shia LaBeouf.
I could so see him doing this.
I know, me too.
Oh my God. Meaning he tries to truly live in his role in order to understand it. Because of COVID, he basically hasn't had any work this year. And that's been really stressful on us both. A few weeks back, he got the main part in a play by a major theater director. And so he's over the moon to not just be learning lines again, but working with the greats. He is taking this opportunity extremely seriously. The play is The Metamorphosis, about a German man waking up one day and finding out he has become a monstrous bug, a huge beetle. My husband has the main beetle part. For his method acting, he strapped a big thing of cardboard to his back, like 6 by 4 feet, to give him the immobility of a big flat bug. He spends all his time on the floor scurrying around and hissing and snarling and clicking to communicate.
No.
Yes. That was really good.
Thank you so much.
Wow, maybe you should try this.
I'm going to when I get home.
This isn't really a problem for me because we have enough space in our one-bedroom apartment. The real issue is that since bugs are sensitive to light, he spends most of the day hiding under the couch. Sleeping and snarling.
Oh.
This sucks because the couch is the only place in our apartment where I can sit to do work for my company during the day. I don't have a desk, but it's also the only place where he can conveniently lie flat and hide. This was going on for the last week. I kept tripping over his cardboard shell when I walked past the couch, and his sub-couch noises would disrupt me while I was working. So I kind of lost it while he was sleeping in bed, and I threw out the couch. I replaced it with a nice big desk and chair from IKEA that I can work on, and he couldn't hide under. This gets to the am I the asshole question. Mm-hmm. He is now complaining that I threw out his couch. True. That nowhere else in the apartment is quite as good for being a bug. I'm not sure. And that me sabotaging his ability to be bug-like is compromising our finances. Not really true. I make more money than he does. He has a point on that throwing out his couch might have been over the line, but there wasn't really a good spot for my work desk anywhere else in the apartment. And frankly, the bug under the couch thing was driving me nuts. His method acting still seems to be going fine. Mm-hmm. He's now spending most of his days under a blanket fort in our bedroom.
See, she made him level up with his acting choices. She was like, well, what will this beetle do without a couch? You can have the couch everywhere.
Yeah. I mean, beetles don't have couches. Beetles got to improvise. So beetle,
yeah,
there we go with the fort.
Say yes and, King. Learn a new trick.
I think that's even challenging his acting more. Like exactly. He's becoming better because he's really thinking outside mm-hmm. the box.
She's training him.
Exactly. Those noises would drive me nuts. Mm-hmm. So she goes on, so no permanent damage appears to have been done other than the couch, which kind of needed to be replaced anyways.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I love this one personally.
Hilarious.
I think it's amazing. I love that he is taking his job so seriously.
Many
people can't relate to that. I can kind of see both sides here. Like, I mean, sure, he's a bit weird, but also if you're married to somebody, like,
you know,
you need to just kind of accept them, you know, like clearly if he's doing this, he's done something similar before.
Oh, for sure. She knows what she was getting herself into
with
the method acting.
Like, right.
Method actors go above and beyond.
And granted, she probably never knew he'd be cast as a beetle, but still, true. Like she knows who she married, and you can't really like at that point be like, no, I need to change you. However, I don't think that throwing away the couch was really so terrible when he's constantly not really considering her sanity.
No.
So
a one bedroom apartment.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of space to like separate the two.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And she needed a workbench, which I feel like him needing to hide under the couch to be a bug isn't as important as her needing to do her work.
No. I wonder if she, like, because she doesn't really mention that she asked him to stop.
Yeah.
Like, kind of passive aggressive.
Right.
Slash aggressive, just like throwing the couch out.
I mean, I'm sure she's asked him to stop. I mean, I guess I can't say for sure, but like.
But you'd think so.
I'm just imagining myself in that situation. I would have like lost it and been like, please stop clicking and scurrying around our home when I'm trying to make our family money.
Money. I have ADHD, as you know, like you do as well. Mm-hmm. And so like all of these noises for me would put me over the edge. Like, I cannot focus on multiple things at the same time. Mm-hmm. If someone was, like, crawling around, clicking and, like,
right.
hissing, I would lose it.
There's a line of where it's like, oh, I'm making my wife's life very difficult and hard to do her own stuff, and I'm impeding on her career. It's like,
yeah,
because he's recognizing that she made it harder to be a bug and he's so mad about that, but he's not going to recognize that like he's been making her career also very difficult to
yeah,
do.
Yeah, more like all about him.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So like, I don't think there's anything wrong with him method acting, being a bug, being his quirky self, because mm-hmm. like, you know, don't try to change people. But like,
no.
I do think there's a lack of consideration in the way he's going about it. You know, like maybe he can have his bug time in that a few days a week and he goes to the park. Mm-hmm. No, she would hate that too. But find like another way to practice your bug stuff. Do it in the bedroom maybe. I don't know.
That, but also I think the park would really put the method acting over the edge.
True.
Like that would be the ultimate space.
True. Release your bug husband into the wild and see what he does.
That's where bugs belong.
I like that this is kind of thematic to the last one also. Mm-hmm. I love that this is like the ant guy. Oh my God, the bug guy would be terrified of the anteater man.
Oh my God, he'd be horrified.
They should reenact something together.
We should connect them somehow.
We should.
Should definitely try to connect them.
Because the beetle man would have to be like so terrified. And then the ant guy would be like, please, can I eat you?
I'm just horrified by both of these.
Yeah. And like, I feel for the man being like, listen, you know, I love method acting and I am literally cast as a beetle. So I'm going to be beetling. But at the same time, it's like, how much can you hide under a couch and learn from that?
Yeah. Like, there's only so many times you can hide under the couch and truly say you're learning something new.
And also, I would say this woman does sound kind of like a saint. And I don't think that her just throwing out the couch is like some awful thing to do after how much she has put up with.
Yeah. Well, she made like a little side comment that I did just skip over. Mm-hmm. But he only acts like a bug during working hours. So like a 9 to 5.
Okay.
So.
And that's when she's working at home as well.
Exactly.
I'm shocked that this relationship survived the pandemic. Congratulations to them. This sounds so difficult.
Truly.
It would be nice if she could, like, go somewhere else during the day. But that's, yeah.
It's like a WeWork situation.
So when she is trying to work, he is clicking and screeching and scurrying with his big cardboard box.
Yeah. The box, too. 6 feet by 4 feet. That's fucking big.
That is such a funny visual. That's literally hilarious.
I wish she would have posted a picture.
This man, like...
I really am sad that there's no
picture. I wish there were YouTube videos. I would love to see his performance at home.
Wait, I wonder
if we could find the play about a beetle.
That's literally what I'm Googling. I'm Googling the name of the play because I wonder if there's actual pictures of him online.
Oh my God. And we show up and then we say, are you this man?
Is this you?
This you?
Okay. The play looks horrifying.
Okay. That makes sense to me.
That's one still.
Oh.
If you're listening and not watching, it's like two people in like latex leather full suits and then a man on the ground, like turned over.
This is him.
If this is the right play, this is him.
Wait, does it say like the year? Is this like a recent? He is killing the bug vibe, by the way. Just so you guys know, he is really embodying
the beetle.
So congratulations to him on that. Why can't he just like spend all that time watching beetles and stuff like that? And maybe like quietly in the closet? Like beetles spend the most time in dark little tiny places. So put him in the closet.
True. This one is old, so this is not a recent one. So we're going to have to find out what year, 2020.
I hope it's just like a local, like really tiny theater production. He's like doing all of that for what?
I know.
Like literally me in high school spending all of my time practicing for theater. And you just were like, a theater for girl. What?
You were a theater girl. I love that.
We love theater girls. I mean, we don't, but like we can appreciate it.
Hey, it made you a well-rounded individual.
Thank you so much.
Did.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'm not seeing anything. I'm going to do some more research and see if I can find him because...
Yeah, when we're off the air, we're going to find this man and we can post a picture of it on your Instagram.
Yeah, that was the same play though, but each director can kind of adapt differently.
Yeah, that one looked a bit high budget, so...
It did. I don't know. I'll post the pictures because it's a little terrifying, you guys.
Hopefully that's like the most obnoxious role he ever has to practice for. Although, like, let's hope he doesn't ever get cast as something scary, like a serial killer.
Oh, my God.
Because when actors do that, like, it permanently messes up their psyches.
It does. Like, it really takes a toll. Like, look at
Heath Ledger
mm-hmm. and, like, the Joker. Like,
he locked himself in, like, a, I don't know, hotel room or something for, like, 2 months, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Or I don't know the exact details, so I don't want to try to pretend I do. But it was something really extreme. And a lot of actors do that, not even just emotionally, but, like, with their bodies. They'll do crazy things, like lose weight or, like, gain weight or so many things that are objectively not good for you.
Oh, my God. So bad.
And it's like, congratulations. You did make some beautiful art. But imagine being that person's significant other. That's got to be like so stressful.
Ugh. Or just them. Like I think Tom Hanks had to lose a bunch of weight and then gain a bunch of weight. And he actually gave himself diabetes.
Oh, my God.
From like, how unhealthy he had to be to like gain the weight back.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
I'm so glad we have like CGI now, like Chris Evans in the, when he was Captain America and they made him really skinny for that first and like really short and skinny. Like, thank God he didn't have to actually do that to his body.
Yeah. Or the body suits. Cause, who's the other Chris Hemsworth in Thor, and he has like the big beer belly dad bod.
Yeah, I don't know if Chris Hemsworth could look like that if he tried in real life. So yeah.
I don't think he could. And honestly, like I've tried one of his workouts. Mm-hmm. The man is a beast.
Oh. Like I would not try a Chris Hemsworth workout. That doesn't sound like something that, well, maybe that could be my goal.
It was motivating watching him because you're right. Like, oh shit, like, okay, he's still moving. I can do it. Like, but I don't know. Maybe this is why I don't work out anymore because
You put your
put my body through that
too much.
It's too
much. Maybe work up to the Chris Hemsworth routine.
I know.
But yeah, that's interesting. I feel like she kind of knows what she's signed up for, but maybe she thought it would be a phase. Who knows?
Well, hopefully they'll get a better couch out of the deal. And yeah. I hope the play goes.
And you know, if you're listening, have a discussion about the clicking.
Yeah. And just, I don't know.
Good luck. Good luck to you. Praying for you. Yeah. Thoughts and prayers.
I hope it went well. There's no update on the post and the top comments are just...
we would love to come see the show, queen. Yeah.
Send us tickets.
Give us a flyer.
Yeah, send us tickets. I'm just going to see if she posted anything else on her account. Nothing.
Damn.
Nothing.
That's so unfortunate.
Yeah.
Maybe the creepy listening algorithm will put it on her page and she'll DM you.
Yeah. So here's the thing. I'm creeping on one of her comments. Mm-hmm. They live in Northern California. It was a very nice mid-century modular couch. Honestly, probably looks like the one we're sitting on. Mm-hmm. It was tall wooden legs, so it was easy to get under for him. But this thread was posted 6 months ago and she goes, the premiere will be next year in Los Angeles. So
we literally are going.
We're
gonna
find,
we are literally we, going to Bugman show.
We are gonna find Metamorphosis
and we're gonna get pictures there. With them. Oh my
we
gosh.
We need to.
Okay, so
we need to.
We can totally find this when we're done recording. We're gonna find it, we're gonna go, yes. And we're gonna have literally the time of our lives.
This is gonna be great.
Oh my God,
we are gonna fangirl so hard over Bug Boy.
We can make merch. We can be wearing like shirts that say we love
Beetle Guy. Where's your couch?
Beetle Guy. Be more considerate of your wife.
I love this.
Oh, it's so funny.
We're going.
Okay, I'm so excited.
It's set. This one is going to leave you feeling a certain way, I think.
Oh, God.
Am I the asshole for refusing to apologize for throwing away my dinner instead of letting my fiancé have it? I, female 22, have been with my fiancé, male 20, for 2 years, and we recently got engaged. I handle cooking while he takes care of all the other stuff, including rent and utilities. He's been eating a lot lately. I started cooking in large pots and buying extra ingredients. He usually tells me what he'd like to eat for dinner. Note, I only cook dinner 3 times a week. Other than that, we have plenty of leftovers. So, on to the situation. Last night, I cooked dinner early because he wanted to eat early. I prepared his plate and put my plate in the fridge, ready to reheat for later. I was finished with studying and took a shower, then went into the kitchen to reheat my dinner and sat at the table by myself and began eating. My fiancé came out of the bedroom saying he smelled the food while he was inside playing video games and thought of joining me because he was hungry. Without even asking, he put his hand on my plate, wanting to eat from it. I stopped him and told him he was being selfish as he already had his, a larger portion of what was cooked, dinner, and the food on my plate was barely enough for me. He complained about being hungry from playing video games. I told him I was hungry because of studying. He made a face and went to grab a spoon so we could eat together. I pulled my plate away and pointed at the fridge, telling him there was some leftovers in the fridge and he could go ahead and reheat some if he was so hungry. Mm-hmm. He refused and insisted to share my dinner. I stood my ground and didn't let him. He got all pissed, threw his spoon in the sink, and spit in my plate.
What? Oh, I would shank him. I would take my utensil and I would put it in his hand.
I would not handle this well.
Spit?
At all.
That is such a disrespectful act.
That's abusive.
Yeah, that's very, very disrespectful.
That is abuse.
Like, we have talked about the worst ways you can argue with somebody, and that is
the worst.
The worst.
The worst. I was 100% taken by surprise and was so livid and disgusted. I shouted, "What the fuck did he just do?" He just smirked at me, telling me to enjoy as he walked out of the room. I called him fucking childish, and he turned around and walked back in saying I was the one acting like a high school bully for refusing to let him share my dinner and telling him...
A high school bully.
He's so ridiculous. And telling him to just have leftovers. I said he was being selfish and petty to spit on my plate to stop me from eating, and he managed to do it. I was so upset and couldn't eat what was on my plate. It was gross and disgusting. I threw it in the garbage can, and he threw another fit asking why I threw away perfect food, and he was counting on me giving it to him after he spit on it. Ugh. We had a major fight, probably the worst fight we've ever had thus far. He says I was wrong, I escalated, and wants me to apologize first so we could put this past us, but I said no. No way I'd apologize after he ruined my dinner and disregarded the time and effort I made to prepare dinner.
That is very messed up.
I just like don't understand.
Like, why would it ever go there? Why would it ever go there? I just like cannot imagine like how hateful you have to feel in a moment to like do that. You know what I mean? Like you have to feel so like... I don't know. You just like aren't even treating that person like a human.
No, you're totally disregarding them as a person. And this is your fiance. You're supposed to love them.
And like, let her just fucking eat. Let her eat. Like she wants to have food. Let her eat.
Why do you feel so entitled to someone else's food?
No, that's so fucked up.
And there's leftovers in the fridge. It takes 2 seconds to scoop something on a plate or a bowl and put it in the microwave.
Yeah, but he's got Fortnite to get back to.
Oh, fucker. This is so, so bad.
Oh, my God.
This would be a relationship ending for me.
Yeah, me too. I'm glad that they're not married yet.
This is...
And, like, yeah. What's worse, I feel... Maybe not worse, but, like, the fact that now that that moment has come and passed and it's, like, another day, he still isn't even understanding that, like, he's the one who should apologize. It's not like this happened and then the next day he was like, oh, my God, that was really messed up of me. I'm so sorry. Like, that would still be bad. But the fact that even now, still, he's like, no.
He's standing his ground.
You didn't give me your food and that was deserved.
You escalated this.
Like, how? How is she escalating it? By just not giving the food? Like, just by not giving it to him?
Who knows? And throwing it away.
And, like, you just know if he's that selfish and he's probably so bad in bed.
Like, it does translate to other areas.
Honestly, he's literally not considering the fact that she needs to eat to survive. There's no way that he is, like, a generous or even equitable partner.
I'm blown away by this one. Like, I literally was about ready to, like, toss my phone. And, like, if I would have been her and someone spit in my food and that plate... Like, I get, like, don't fight violence with violence.
Right.
But, like, that thing would have been tossed at him.
Yeah, that is very messed up. I would love to ask her to please leave him, but I don't know if she'll hear us. Are there comments? Crossed. Like, are there people being like, girl?
Yes. Top comment. Not the asshole. And I sincerely hope you've already broken up with this man. Do not tie your life to his. Mm-hmm. Next one is like a million red flags. He dropped about 500 of these. Not the asshole, OP, but you could drive a B-52 bomber through your boyfriend's asshole. It is so big. He spit in your food that you were eating because he is an angry, angry little man. Do not let anyone disrespect you like that. It will only get worse.
Yeah, I mean, like, they're not even married yet and he's doing shit like that. No. Like, that is such a 500 red flags. Because that's not a good sign of behavior to come.
No. And like, he was so malicious and like toxic. Mm-hmm. The fact that he spit in her food in hopes that she would then give it to him. But it's like, okay, this is just over food. What is it going to be like down the road when you get in a fight over something that is like more
that's like substantial? So true. Like, this is literally such a low stakes reason to have that aggressive of behavior. Mm-hmm. Like, all that he had to do is fucking heat up some food. Literally just heat up some food, but he wanted her specifically, which is like kind of a sign of wanting somebody to show that like dominance. They value, yeah, dominance, and like mm-hmm. that they value you over their own like survival, and like it's true. A very creepy like instinct for him to think, no, I need to have exactly what like she wants right now yeah. in order to feel like I'm in control, and like this is
it's some very like toxic alpha masculinity mm-hmm. bullshit.
Yeah, like the place it's coming from is not good.
No. This comment, like, really, really stood out, too, and it got a shit ton of awards, and they go...
Comments get awards on Reddit?
They get awards and, like, presents, and apparently, like, you like these people have to spend money to give the awards, so it's, like, it's really, it's kind of crazy.
People can get money for good comments on Reddit?
See, that's what I don't know, but I know that it costs money to buy the awards.
Okay.
So then I don't know if, like, once you get the awards, you can cash out.
I could make millions on Reddit. I've got comments.
Another avenue we should explore.
Thank you so much.
So this comment, though, this isn't a red flag at all. Red flags are alarming, potentially suspicious behavior that indicates someone might be abusive. This is straight up abusive. Not the asshole. And for the love of God, don't marry this dude.
Oh my gosh. When you started that like sentence, I was like, oh, I'm about to be mad at someone. But then, because he was like, this isn't a red flag. And I was like, but then they were like,
they recovered.
Yeah. You're so true.
Yeah. No, this is abusive. This is very like psychologically, mentally, emotionally abusive.
Maybe they need to stop playing these video games. I actually don't know if that's a thing. Do violent video games make people feel violent?
There's a lot of research on that.
I don't remember if it was concluded one way or the other. But there's like, a lot. But maybe he's coming off of that like, I'm a god. I kill people. Like, I get all the food I want.
Gamer high?
Yeah, I feel like gamer, like, convos and environments can just be, like, not the best.
Yeah, especially know what I mean? For women.
Yeah.
Like, the TikToks of women gamers who, like, just go into a game and they're like, hi, and it's instant. Go make me a sandwich, bitch.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah.
This man needs some... not help. Actually, he needs to be like isolated on an island.
Yeah, he needs an intervention of some sort. Mm-hmm. My dad is like standing behind us too, and he's like doing like a shoot yourself
so true.
Charades over go there. Off. Yeah, he's my dad is listening again, waiting for his shot back in the spotlight. But yeah, this one run. Far and fast because...
Yeah, there are so many different like parts of that that I feel like indicate really unhealthy behaviors, but also like mm-hmm. ways of viewing his partner and like, I don't know, just the kind of dynamic he wants to have with her, which is not good.
Yeah, not good
and
at all.
And he doesn't even want to apologize now. No. That's crazy to me.
The fact that he's sticking to his
guns.
He's
not even like, I'm so sorry, baby. I never would have meant to do that to you. He's like, you better apologize, bitch. You did not give me your food.
No, fuck him. He's not cooking at all.
You made me spit.
Bitch, this dude sucks. Mm-hmm. Like, absolutely sucks. Throw him away.
Throw him away.
Throw him away.
Wash your hands. Never open the trash again.
Good riddance. Okay, last one. We're ending. We started out very positive and like funny.
Yeah.
And we took a turn because this one too is
this
like,
one's also going to make me mad.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm ready.
Am I the asshole for throwing away my girlfriend's dead best friend's t-shirt?
Yes. Terrible. There's no more context needed.
Terrible.
What the fuck?
Yeah. So he goes, hear me out. I know it sounds bad. I have been with my girlfriend for a couple of years and we live together. My girlfriend lost her best friend of 10 years, her senior year of college. They had gone through a lot together, but the best friend had some untreated mental issues and she lost the fight against her depression. My girlfriend was the one who found her. They lived together at the time. This caused my girlfriend to spiral. She wound up helping the parents go through her stuff. She now has a box of old journals that were her best friend's. They had a pact that if one dies, they wouldn't let anyone else read them. Too embarrassing or something. A t-shirt and some art she had done and a bunch of scrapbooks. My girlfriend was in a dark place for a long time. I met her a couple years after the incident and it's taken time, but she has gotten better. She was and is in counseling for grief and other stuff. She used to talk about the friend constantly, but now it's down to every once in a while. Now, generally, when I clean, I take stuff and put it in a bag and tell her to go through it before I throw it out. Today, I was going through our closet and was making a donate/throwaway pile. I asked her to go through it when I was done, but she had a lot of work and said it was probably fine. She generally doesn't care too much about her clothes, and I think she was overwhelmed. Well, I threw out the stuff that was worn and old, ripped, etc. Then, after I showered, my girlfriend came yelling at me, demanding to know where the t-shirt is. I asked her, what t-shirt? And she said the one belonging to her dead best friend. I asked if she lost it, and she said no, it was in the closet. So then I said, it might have gotten thrown out, and she just started screaming at me. I said I asked her to go through the piles, but she said no. But then she said that it should have never been in the piles, given how much she has talked about the friend, and that apparently she told me the story behind the t-shirt. I don't recall it. I know there was a story. I knew there was a t-shirt, but I never paid enough attention to which shirt. Well, she has now taken a bag to her brother's. I just don't get why she is so upset. She has all of these other things to remember her by. A t-shirt isn't that big of a deal.
Okay. I don't know how I feel about him, like, just not knowing it was the t-shirt. Like, I guess I don't fully blame him for that part, but mm-hmm. the way he's reacting to this is not empathetic at all. Like, he should be like, oh my God, I feel so bad for doing this. Like, that was a stupid mistake. I should have paid better attention to, like, when you're telling me about this. Like, clearly he knows that this is very important to her because he was describing her mental state, like, at the beginning of this Reddit post. Like, in detail, he very clearly understood, like, all of those things. But like, he now doesn't really understand why it matters to her when, like, he saw how torn up she's been.
Yeah. The last sentence, I don't get why she is so upset. She has all of these other things to remember her by. Like, it doesn't matter what else she has. That t-shirt was important.
Yeah.
Bottom line.
Right. And, like, I think maybe I'll 10% blame him for, like, accidentally choosing that. And, like, you know, she also probably should have put it somewhere different or, like, made it very clear to him and been like, this is the shirt, if mm-hmm. that was never mentioned. But, like, the way he's treating it now and being like, I have no idea why she's mad at me, that's really not fair.
No, not at all. And, like, it sounds like she found out pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Like, it sounds like he just, like, literally threw the stuff away in the donate pile or whatever and mm-hmm. then was showered and she found out. Like, I would, if say I made a mistake and did this, I would immediately be trying to fix it. Mm-hmm. I would run down to the trash or I would run to the donation place and try to get it back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's not gone unless you literally put it in the trash and then the fucking dumpster truck came.
Yeah. This should have been, like, reacted to as if it was an awful mistake that, like, he felt so bad about and didn't mean. And then maybe it could have been okay. But I feel like probably part of why she left is that he responded, like, why is it such a big deal? Like, that that's only going to further her frustration and anger and, like, reaction. That's going to escalate it.
Yeah. Well, and the fact, too, what I'm kind of getting stuck on with this one, like, he talks about how important the friend is, mm-hmm. but then he's like, I know she told me a story, but, like, honestly, I just didn't listen.
Yeah, you're right. That part was also very icky sounding. Yeah. Like, I know that it was really, really important to her, and she told me a story. I don't really remember what it was. I wasn't paying close attention. Like, what?
I don't remember the shirt.
This was clearly, like, a very vulnerable moment for her, and, like, that's probably part of the frustration, too, is it probably is an indicator of larger issues she has in the relationship mm-hmm. of him just, like, not paying attention to things that are super important to her, and this was clearly, like, a very strong manifestation of that.
100%.
I don't know. Poor girl.
So, top comment on the original post, you're the asshole. I was on your side thinking you just honestly fucked up with no ill intent until I got to your last two sentences.
Yeah, that's how I felt too.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh my God, that's awful for both of them because, like, he had no idea. He was just trying to clean, made a big mistake.
Yeah.
But no, it sounds like from his language and, like, just random little parts in there that he just truly doesn't pay much attention
mm-hmm.
to things she says that are important to her. And now he's like, why are you so mad? Which all of those things are just going to make it even bigger than what it already was, which it already is going to upset her a lot.
Yeah. It's just, it's heartbreaking. So there is an update.
Okay.
So with my last post, I figured I owed you guys an update. I had apologized at the time, but I didn't think I fucked up that badly. At this point, some of this stuff felt excessive. I was the one going through our shared closet because we have been doing an overall deep clean of the apartment. As far as getting rid of her stuff, I was only throwing out stuff that was clearly ripped. She was aware this was happening. I did try to get the shirt back. By the time I got out there, the trash had been picked up. I called the company, but they said it was gone. After reading some comments, I called the best friend's parents. My girlfriend still goes around the holidays over there and briefly explained what happened. They said that over the past year, they have been downsizing and they went through her stuff and half got donated, but the other half was sitting in her sister's attic in a box if I wanted to ask her. I called the sister, told her what happened, and asked if there was anything she would be willing to let my girlfriend have. She said she has a couple sorority shirts that she would be willing to give her, and apparently the friend had two necklaces and she would be willing to give one to my girlfriend. I said that would be great. I talked to my girlfriend and let her know where to send it. I drove to the brother's house to talk to my girlfriend. When I got there, I hadn't even gotten out of my car before her youngest brother and cousin came out and just started screaming at me. Her cousin said I had no right to have any opinion about the best friend, that she was some amazing person, and I had been so disrespectful about her.
Wait, what opinion did he have?
I don't know. I feel like he's...
He's keeping some things out, I think. I think he's leaving things out here.
He's conveniently not disclosing.
Like, what was the opinion that her family members are so upset about?
I know. He then said that if her best friend were still alive, she would have talked my girlfriend into dumping me years ago.
Go off!
I felt that was uncalled for. Her brother started telling me to go to hell and that I was always jealous of the best friend and that I need to get off his property. I tried to explain I was here to fix it, but he wouldn't even let me see my girlfriend. Apparently, she is in rough shape and had to take days off work because she is having some kind of meltdown. So I left. I got home, and I got a call from the sister. I picked up and didn't know what my girlfriend told her, but she laid into me and said I was some unforgivable asshole stomping all over her sister's memory.
Damn.
Yeah.
Oh, he's such a victim, isn't he? I don't trust this man. I think he's been saying some shit.
Mm-hmm. She said she would be more than happy to send my girlfriend the items we talked about, but to her brother or grandmother's house, since I can't be trusted. A couple hours later, I got a text from her saying it's over and she's breaking up with me. Her brothers came by an hour later to get her stuff, and she is now refusing to take any of my calls. So, for those who hoped she would dump me, you got your wish.
Oh, whatever. Grow up, you little bitch.
A little victim complex.
Oh, my God.
I couldn't imagine breaking up with her over this, especially since we were together almost 3 years, and she can't even answer her phone to dump me.
I feel like, okay, we're only getting this man's side and like what he chooses to tell, and it still doesn't make him look great.
No.
So I imagine if the girlfriend were giving us like the actual context mm-hmm. of like, I'm sure he made little comments when he's like, it's not that big of a deal. Like he probably said some shit along with that that clearly upset the family and her and like
100%.
Brought it to this place. Like, sir, tell us the whole truth. I wish that she could tell us what he said.
I know. The top comment on this one, I get the feeling there's something important you are leaving out. After you spoke with the sister and told her what happened, she agreed to send a couple items to replace the shirt. But then she got the story from your ex and now is furious with you. What are you leaving out of the story?
Right. Because clearly, like, when he was asking for the new stuff, he would have told her in that conversation that he accidentally threw it out. And yeah. She, like, didn't freak out in that conversation. So, like, she knew that. But then there was something else that happened that he's not mentioning that brought it to a different place.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. It's about to get really juicy.
Oh, there's more?
There's more.
Oh, I'm so excited.
The next comment goes, I bet you a dollar boyfriend has tried to get rid of all items before or expressed repeated irritation with the stories/importance this friend had in his ex's life.
Mm-hmm.
And someone goes, he did. He made her take down 6 pictures she had of her friend in their house and also complains in another comment that she was still seeing her dead best friend's family and friends once a year. He also bitched about finding her looking at old videos of her best friend in the middle of the night.
What is he so insecure about? Why is this such a thing? This is so weird. This
so
is
weird.
Very, very insecure.
Yeah.
I had an ex get like upset about my little red panda stuffed animal that I sleep with every night. And he was like mean to my red panda stuffed animal. And I almost killed him. I was like, first of all, it's not alive. I just love to cuddle it. And I do care for Mr. Rover. But like, why are you mad at him?
What the fuck? How is someone so insecure and so threatened by a stuffed animal?
I don't know.
A dead girl. Like, this was someone that was so important to her and her life. And she's gone. Mm-hmm. There is no competition because she's literally gone.
Yeah. And like, if she was alive, like, she wouldn't be looking at pictures of her in the middle of the night, obviously. Like, why does your world need to revolve only around you?
Yeah. Well, and in that comment, they go, if it's in the middle of the night, it means she was trying to hide it. And yet he says she was being excessive.
Yeah.
He is a narcissistic control freak. And that poor girl dodged a massive bullet.
Yeah, even in his original one, he was like, she used to talk about her all the time, but now she only mentions her like every now and then. Yeah. It's probably because of how you react.
Yeah.
It's probably not because she doesn't care anymore. Like, you're trying to make her not care because you're insecure. That is literally crazy.
So toxic.
No offense to crazy people. I am one of you.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely disgusting. This is a big trend that I've actually seen on Reddit, though, where like boyfriends are threatened by like their girlfriend's ex-fiance who passed away. And like, this one guy went so far as to like, this girl had her old locket that he, like, her ex-fiance who had passed gave her, and he threw it away.
What the fuck?
Yeah, like, people are so threatened, and it's like, why? How? Why? For what? Like, there's no competition when that person is gone.
Yeah, that's very gross. I don't understand like how you can be so controlling over someone's like attention and time that like a dead person who was even platonic could like
platonic
he was mad that she saw her family once a year. Like, what? Why would that matter? Like, you could see anybody once a year. Is she allowed to have friends?
That is so strange, because like, I don't know, like, I'm super close with like some of my friends' family.
Yeah.
Like, their family becomes your family.
Yeah.
And if you were friends for 10 years, like, she died her senior year of college, which, okay, you're like 22. So if they were friends for 10 years.
Yeah, that's a lot of time and like all the big life moments.
Well, they started out being friends so young. So yeah, like all those life moments from 12 until like 22 or college graduation age, like, that's a lot of life to live with someone.
Oh my God. I am so glad that it ended with her dumping him. And I good love that he was trying to be like, so everyone's saying she should dump me. Congrats. You got your wish.
You got your wish.
It's like, oh my God, please stop projecting on everybody else.
Cry a little more.
He almost did get me to feel like bad for him in the first post when he was like, I had no idea. And I was like, oh, he probably is about to say how bad he feels. But no. He's just like, my girlfriend's overreacting, right? Like, she did not do anything to make this clear to me. Like, clearly he does know how much it mattered to her because he's been bothered by it.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
well, and it's like, if it was a true accident and you know you made like an honest mistake.
Yeah.
You wouldn't be writing into Reddit.
Yeah.
Asking if you were the asshole.
That's so true. I, like, there is a part of me that does think it maybe was on purpose.
100%.
Yeah. I mean, if he's making her take down, like, other things. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
And also the way he described her, like, having a breakdown as having some little meltdown or something like that. He said some kind of words a where meltdown. I was like, that's not how you describe someone going through a hard time when you care about them.
Yeah. Like, do you even like your girlfriend? Because all signs point to no.
Yeah.
Like, big fucking no.
Well, happy ending with her breaking up with him. I'm glad we got to know that, because I would be so upset right now if we didn't know that or if they were together still.
I'd be heartbroken.
I'm glad she has, like, people around her that, like, she was honest with and, like, told the story to and they're, like, stay away from him.
Oh, the brother and the cousin coming outside?
Yeah.
Round of applause for that. Like,
go off.
What was the comment? Like, if her friend was alive, she would have convinced her to dump you years ago. Like, love that.
Like, and, like, probably true.
Give him a little bit of a wake-up call.
And that's why she misses her so much.
Yeah. Ugh. I can't imagine. Like, I can't imagine. So terrible.
Well, we got a lot of good contenders today.
So many.
So many fun little friends with their bugs and their...
The beetle
toxicity guy. And their spit and their clacks and their...
God, some of these I would kill if they happened to me. Like,
I know. I was like listening to most of these thinking, oh my God, my response to this would be so much worse.
I know. I don't know how some of these people keep it together, because I like the spit one.
Yeah.
Dude would be out of the house.
Yeah. He would
out of the house.
Be missing a limb.
Done. Did you have any little stories you wanted to share?
I don't have like stories, but I would love to share a couple of my She Raids Dogs posts as of late, because, you know, they're kind of similar.
You got some good contenders always.
This one is very short, but I really loved this interaction. So a girl DM'd him, "I'm swamped at work today trying to catch up and don't think I'm going to be able to make it work tonight. Can we reschedule?" And he replied, "Hey, no, I'd rather not. Let's just stick with today." Smiley face.
What?
So funny to me. She's like, "Sorry, like, I'm really swamped. Don't think I can make it work. Can we reschedule?" He's like, "You know what? She left an opening. She left a little bit of an opening there."
The question mark at the end. Like, sir, it doesn't work like that.
Yeah, someone commented, "That smiley face at the end is choosing violence."
What a dick.
That's so funny.
This is why he's still single.
And then here's a really good one. "I'm very happy to have cyber met you and hope we have a wonderful relationship for a long time, starting today. However, I want to give you informed consent that I have diabetes, so I don't wear condoms. Is that all right with you if we develop a passionate relationship? I'd love to in your and mouth after we make love, and 69 since I've had 30 years of relationships without condoms, and I have neuropathy, and it is very hard to get and stay hard with condoms. I hope you understand my medical situation." This man had, I literally Googled, I was like, do people with diabetes, can they not wear condoms? And like, of course that's not true, but I literally did Google it to make sure first.
I have no fucking words for this at all. Like, diabetes causes like numbness and tingling. Okay. So like, that's the neuropathy, like mm-hmm. neuropathy, depending on how you like, whatever the fuck you want to say it. But like,
I don't know how to say words.
I literally am in healthcare and I'm like, neuropathy, like mm-hmm. everyone says it different anyways. So like, I don't fucking know, but I'm like, okay, but like, I've never heard of losing sensation in your dick.
"Hope you understand my medical situation, but we cannot use condoms."
Also, like, how soon is this coming out? Like, "Happy to have cyber met you." Like, is yeah. this like one of the initial DMs? Like, what are we working with?
Well, I'm sure that they haven't met yet. Otherwise, he would have said, "I'm very happy to have met you." He wouldn't have said cyber met. This is clearly like they have not even met.
No, 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 no.
And like
30 years of passionate sex without condoms.
Like, what?
No one needs this information, sir. My dad is like blown away. He is up out of his seat to hear this one. He is shaking his head. You guys, like, oh my God, I'm disturbed. I'm absolutely disturbed.
Do you want me to do one more?
Oh yeah, keep them coming.
Okay, okay. So the guy said, "None of my attempts to make you happy mean anything to you." And she was like, "I try to show you that I love you as much as I can. I don't know what to do. I'm sorry." And he said, "Just let me die." She said, "What?" He said, "Let me die. It doesn't matter because you were happy." And then he sends a screenshot from her Instagram with the caption, "You don't look sad." And it's her at a Shawn Mendes concert. And she says, "What's wrong with me being happy though?" And he said, "I'm not as good as Shawn. Don't say shit about he doesn't compare to me because you know damn well he's more talented, better looking. He's never met you and makes you happier than me. You'd probably rather spend a day with him over me. And the only reason you stopped idolizing him was because we started officially dating. But you still posted stuff when I told you I loved you. I know that doesn't matter how many times you tell me I'm special. I know he'll always have a place in your heart." And then he sends a picture of like a sign she made, I guess, that just says, "Get well soon, Shawn," with an exclamation point with like a heart. And he said, "Every time I see your drawn hearts, I'll think of Shawn and realize it's nothing special just for me."
Oh my God.
Shawn Mendes.
Is this man okay?
Like, he's mad that she was happy at a concert. He was like, "I don't make you happy like that." Like, okay, that's a you problem.
This guy and the last one who threw away the t-shirt need to meet because yeah. they sound like they have—
Wait, so true.
Like a narcissistic victim complex.
And these people were in college as well. This isn't like, this isn't middle schoolers, which I know—
I was going to say, how old are they?
No, they're in college.
Oh my God, no.
But they are broken up now. She did give me the update.
Thank God.
The nice thing about like my posts is that people submit them to me so I can yeah. always follow up and be like, "Are you guys done? Are Please you, tell me you're done."
Dear Lord, what a man. Mm-hmm. Put him in some fucking rice because—
Yeah, that is very similar to the one that you said. Like, what? "You draw hearts and I'll never feel special again when you draw me a heart because I know you did the same for Shawn."
I don't compare. He's so much more talented than me.
Like, yes, yes, yeah. Shawn Mendes yeah. is more talented than you, bestie. Yeah.
Like, clearly. Look at him. He's touring. Like, what?
Like, that's his job.
He's got Grammys
and
shit.
He's literally famous and has awards.
Like, Kay, a truer statement couldn't be said. What do you want me to say to that?
So fucking funny.
No, no, babe. No, Sean is, like, he doesn't compare to you.
Sending her a picture of her Instagram, like, you look happy here. Nothing you say matters. Let me die.
What are you supposed to do at a concert? Like, sit there and fucking sulk?
Look sad because your boyfriend, who's the only person who can give you joy, isn't there. That's all you can do.
Sometimes you just, like, wonder, like, why do people, like, why do men, mm-hmm. like, sometimes women fit the box too. Why do women? Like, what mm-hmm. the fuck?
I don't know. I love that though.
That's
like literally a college age man so broken up over her enjoying herself at a Shawn Mendes concert.
Oh my God.
He's like, I can't make you smile like that.
The diabetes man is going to haunt me.
Yeah.
Absolutely haunt me. Yeah. That one, you know, I've heard a lot of excuses for not wanting to wear a condom.
Oh, mm-hmm.
But that might be... That's definitely sticking in my head forever.
I had another one that was like her DMing him, or not DM, but like texting him, like, I want to use condoms from now on. And him just replying, you're so fucking selfish. Different couple. But like, it's just very sir, funny.
Sir.
You're so fucking selfish. Like, comparatively, the amount that birth control affects women's bodies and like we just put up with that shit, like, please give me a break.
Yeah. Well, and how easy it is for us to get UTIs and
yeah,
like just a dick alone can offset our pHs.
Like, just admit that you have a porn addiction and that's why your dick doesn't work. Like, please.
I just like I don't understand. Maybe buy a condom size that fits, like use lube. Like, mm-hmm. I don't know. Like, that sounds like a...
Yeah. But shout out to all of them. Hope yeah. they're having fun. That's just a little bit of what we do on She Rates Dogs.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Come join Michaela over there and check out our episode.
Yeah. You guys would love it. You get into Morgan's, like, you know, medical jargon. Yeah. Medical jargon. Your educational history.
Mental health.
Your mental health expertise.
Our tangents were on point.
So true.
It was good.
We did tangent a lot.
It was good. That's just the way our little brains work.
Little rat brains.
Little rat brains.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
No, thank you.
I had so much fun.
I know, I did too.
I love the bugs.
I know. We're going to just be bug
We're going to find Beetle Man.
We are finding him. Like, that is on my bucket list now.
And if you guys are interested in also finding Beetle Man and going yes. to his show, follow Two Hot Takes on Instagram and there will be updates posted.
Look at you just plugging me over there. Oh my God. No, but we're seriously going. We should start like a little group and like maybe see if we can get like a bulk ticket price.
Yeah. And we can like frame the playbills and it'll be like the fondest memory. And if we
got to have him sign it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. We got to have the wife. Sign
it. Yeah. She might be a bigger celebrity than him.
At this point. Be like, ma'am, are you okay?
Yes. Oh my God.
Well, do you sleep?
I'm just traumatized by these stories today. Mm-hmm. But there are good and happy, healthy relationships, are there? So
yeah.
Moral of the story, don't stick around for shitty ones.
Don't stick around. Don't settle. Don't like think that the red flags are going to go away. They're only going to heighten.
They get worse.
When you're with somebody, that's great. You should be surprised at like how great they are and how much more they do than you expected. Not mm-hmm. like making little consolations of, no, it's fine that they actually are not great.
No.
Because it just gets worse. No one gets better. They just get worse.
Most times a tiger does not change their stripes.
So true. Mm-mm. I love that quote by Elton John.
Is that Elton John?
No, I have no idea. It's literally no clue.
Why am I so gullible? Why? Why?
I don't know. Elton John said a lot of things.
He's brilliant. I got another pipe in from my dad over there.
Okay, it was Oprah.
that could be more believable. But on that note, until next time.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for having me, guys. Bye.
Bye, guys.